Good morning, students. Now, today we will start our second chapter. The name of the chapter is Relation in Function. Before we start the second chapter, we will discuss the concept of Cartesian product. This word we have heard in 9th standard. See, what exactly we will do in Cartesian product? We will write the order pair PQ such that P belongs to set P and Q belongs to set Q. I will write one example. Let P be the set having element 1 and 2 and Q be the set having elements say A and B. Then Cartesian product of PQ is nothing but the order pair, set of all the order pair where P contain 1, 2 and Q contain AB. So we will write order pair where first element from P and second element from Q. So we will write 1A, 1B, 2A, 2B. This is the answer of PQ. But if anyone asks Q cross P, then first entry from Q and second entry from P. So what we will write here? A1, A2, B1, B2, A1, A2, B1, B2. Thus, we can conclude that PQ and QP are not always same. It is same when P and Q are to same set. Now, we will start our first exercise 2.1, which is based on this property of Cartesian product. Now, first question of exercise 2.1. See, the first question is, if x upon 3 plus 1 y minus 2 by 3 is equal to 5 by 3 comma 1 by 3. Then find the value of x and y. Now, first of all, we know that when two order pair are given and in between them equality is given, means first element equal to first element. So we will write x upon 3 plus 1 is equal to 5 by 3. And second element is same as second element. So y minus 2 by 3 is equal to 1 by 3. Now we will simplify this. We will shift 1 on this side. So x upon 3 is 5 by 3 minus 1. After LCM, it is 5 minus 3 by 3. That is 2 by 3. But 2 by 3 is the answer of x by 3. And therefore, x is equal to 2 because 3, 3 get cancelled. Same way here, y is equal to 1 by 3, this negative 2 by 3 shift on that side. So it is plus 2 by 3. So finally 3 by 3 and that is equal to 1. So y is equal to 1. So finally, the answer of x and y is 2 and 1 respectively. Now, question number 2. As I told you in the example, by taking P and Q as 1, 2 and AB, you have to do the same thing in question number 2. See, question number 2, it is given that if set A has 3 elements, number of element in A is 3, B has 3, 4, 5, B having element 3, 4, 5. Then find the number of element in A cross B. I will again give you an example, previous example only. P contain 2 entries say 1, 2. Q contain 2 entries say AB. And you have observed that the answer of P cross Q contain 2 into 2, 4 entry. You might be remember 1A, 1B, 2 entry, 2A, 2B, remaining 2 entry. So total 4 entry. So in general, we can conclude that the number of element in A cross B is based on the formula N of A cross B, having formula N of A into N of B. Now number of element in A are 3. It is directly given. But B, we can count 1, 2, 3. So that also 3. So in total 9 and 3 exist for number of element in A cross B. Now question number 3. There are two sub question. In question number 3, G is given 7, 8. And H is given 5, 4 and 2. Now, G cross H is my first question. Now, what we will find in G cross H? See, in G cross H, our first element from set G and second element from set H. G cross H, always cross product, Cartesian product gives order pair. So, we will say 7, 5. Then 7, 4, then 7, 2, then 8, 5, 8, 4, 8, 2, 8, 5, and 8, 2 is the last entry. Now, same way, H cross G is my second question that I will give you homework. That you have to solve by yourself. Again, H cross G gives you order pair only. 6 order pair, because H contained 3 element and G contained 2 element. 6 element. But they are not the same 6. The 6 element you have to write by yourself. Now, next question. Question number 4. State whether each of the following statements are true or false. If statement is false, rewrite the given statement correctly. Now here in question number 4, the first statement is P having element MN and Q having element NM. Now they wrote that P cross Q is equal to MN and NM. But we know that P contain 2 entry, Q contain 2 entry, okay. So P contain 2 entry and Q contain 2 entry. So total 2 into 2, 4 entry we have to write in P cross Q. So this answer is false. To make it correct, we have to write remaining 2 entry. Now, first of all, we see that MN is first entry. MM is second entry, which is not here. So that I have to write MM. Now NN is fourth entry, which is not in the given question. So to make it correct, we have to write this 2 entry extra. Clear? Okay. Now same way, sub question number 2. If A and B are non-empty set, then A cross B is also non-empty set of order pair XY, such that X belongs to A and Y belongs to B. We know that if element of XY, see, this is first sub question, this is second sub question. Element of XY is belongs to A cross B. Definitely we can say that first entry from set A and second from set B. So definitely yes, the given statement is true. X belongs to A and Y belongs to B. Now, fifth question. Till question number 4, we have solved the Cartesian product for two sets. Here, there are only one set, say namely A, with entry minus 1 and 1. But the question is A cross A cross A. What do you mean by A cross A cross A? You know that 2 into 2 into 2. So there are in total 8 entry, 2 into 2, 4 into 2, 4 2s are 8. 8 entry we have to write, and each entry contain 3 terms. So what we will write? Minus 1, minus 1, minus 1. This is the first entry. Now minus 1, minus 1, 1. This is my second entry. Now first I will fix minus 1. Then again fix minus 1. And then 1 one times we will write minus 1 and second time we will write plus 1. Now again, minus 1 is fixed. Now I will fix 1. Instead of this minus 1, I will write 1. Then minus 1. And minus 1, 1, 1. Now, this 4 entry are completed. Another 4 entry. 1, 1, 1. 1, 1, minus 1. 1, minus 1, 1. 1, minus 1, minus 1. See, none of the entries match. Okay. Suppose you are not comfortable with this. I will explain you in other method. Now, if minus 1, minus 1. Cross minus 1, minus 1. Which gives you A cross A. What about the answer of A cross A? Minus 1 with minus 1. Write twicely. Minus 1 with minus 1. Now minus 1 with 1. Again, minus 1 with 1. Now 1 with minus 1. And 1 with 1. Now, from first row, we'll write minus 1, minus 1, minus 1, minus 1. Here we'll write 1, 1, 1, 1. See, this 8 entry is same as this 8 entry. Observe this. Minus 1, minus 1, minus 1. Minus 1, minus 1, minus 1. Now, minus 1, minus 1, 1. Minus 1, minus 1, 1. Minus 1, 1, minus 1. Minus 1, 1, minus 1. Minus 1, 1, 1. Minus 1, 1, 1. 1, minus 1, minus 1. 1, minus 1, minus 1. 1 minus 1, 1. 1 minus 1, 1. 1, 1 minus 1. 1, 1 minus 1. And 1, 1, 1. It's 1, 1, 1. See, it is up to you how to write. But it is clear that if there are 2 entry and there are 3 sets, then 2 into 2 into 2, you have to write 8 element which contain triplets. That is 3 entry. Now, next question. Question number 6. I will not solve question number 6. I will give you 6 question as a homework, because order pair are given for A cross B. You have to decide the elements of A and elements of B. We know very well the first entry from A and the second entry from set B. Now, 7th question. 7th question contains A is 1, 2, B is 1, 2, 3, 4, C is 5, 6 and D is 5, 6, 7, 8. You have to verify 2 results. A cross B intersection C is equal to A cross B intersection A cross C, and another one is A cross C is a subset of B cross D. Now first of all, we will write the entry. See here, question number 7. A having element 1, 2. B having element 1, 2, 3, 4. C having element 5, 6. And D having element 5, 6, 7 and 8. I forgot to write 6. 5, 6, 7 and 8. Now, the first question is LHS. A cross B intersection C. Now, first of all, we will find B intersection C. What is the answer of B intersection C? Which element is common? 5. No element is common. So, how many elements are present in 5? 0. And A, 2. What about the answer of 2 into 0? Definitely it is 5. No entries exist in LHS. Now, RHS. Your RHS is A cross B intersection A cross C. It means we have to find A cross B first and then A cross C. A cross B means first element from A, second element from B. So 1, 1, 1, 2, 1, 3, 1, 4. 2, 1, 2, 2, 2, 3, 2, 4. So the entry of A cross B, 1, 1, 1, 2, 1, 3, 1, 4. 2, 1, 2, 2, 2, 3, 2, 4. See, this is your first entry of A cross B. Intersection A cross C means A is 1, 2, B is 5, 6. So 1, 5, 1, 6, 2, 5, 2, 6. 1, 5, 1, 6, 2, 5, 2, 6. What exactly we have to find? We have to find from this set and from this set common element. Now see the common element. 1, 1 is here. There is no 1, 1. Even 5, 6 is not present in this set. So there is no common element. So we can say null set. So both LHS and RHS are same. Hence first one is proved. Now second sub question is A cross C is a subset of B cross D. Second we have to check A cross C is subset of B cross D. So for that we have to find first of all A cross C. You know that A cross C means 1, 5, 1, 6, 2, 5, 2, 6. 1, 5, 1, 6, 2, 5, 2, 6. This is the answer of A cross C. We will separately write A cross C. We will separately write B cross D. Then we will decide. Now B cross D. Observe this B having 4 elements, D having 4 elements. So total 4 into 4, 16 elements we have to write. Now I will write 16 elements. 1 with 5, 1 with 6, 1 with 7, 1 with 8. 1, 5, 1, 6, 1, 7, 1, 8, 2, 5, 2, 6, 2, 7, 2, 8, 3, 5, 3, 6, 3, 7, 3, 8, 4, 5, 4, 6, 4, 7, 4, 8. Now what exactly we have to check? We have to check all the elements of A cross C must be present in B cross D. See, these are the answer of A cross B. And these are the answer of B cross D. See, this is the answer of A cross C. Now check 1, 5 present here, 1, 5 present here, 1, 6 here, 2, 5 here, 2, 6 here. So we can say all 4 elements are present over here. So first statement means first condition A cross C satisfied B cross C, B cross D. Hence, it is proved. So, first and second both are hold. Now, question number 8. See, question number 8 is A having 1, 2, B having 3, 4. Write A cross B. How many subset will A cross B have? List them. Now, first of all, A having 1, 2 and B having 3, 4. So, we will write first of all A having 1, 2 and B having 3, 4. And then we will write the answer of A cross B. A having 1, 2, B having 3, 4. Now, first of all, we have to write the entry of A cross B. A cross B means 1, 3, 1, 4, 2, 3, 2, 4. See, there are 4 elements. So, number of subset is equal to 2 raised to 4, 16 entry you have to write. Which are that 16 entry? Now, first of all, null set. Then, this singleton, this set. So, we will write 1, 3, 1, 4, order pair in curly bracket. 2, 3, 2, 4, see, 0 element, 1, single element, 4, okay, you might be remember, we have discussed this concept in first chapter. There are 4 entry, so there are 0, 1, 4, 1, 4, and 5, total, we know that, there are 16 entry. Okay. See, 4C0, 4C. We have discussed the Pascal triangle. You might be remember the triangle. 1, then 1, 1, then 1, 2, 1, then 1, 3, 3, 1, then 1, then this 6, 1, then this 3, 1 plus 3, that is 4, then this 3 plus 3, 6, then 3 plus 1, 4, then again 1. So here 1, 4, element which contain 2-2 entry, like 1, 3, 1, 4, that kind of 6 entry. Then 1, 3, 1, 4, 2, 3, that kind of 4 entry. And all the 4 entry, that kind of 1 entry. That 16 entry you have to write in the answer of subset of, possible subset of A cross B. Clear? Okay, students. Now we will discuss remaining top question in the next class. Thank you, students.